Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video to any of you having a Ford vehicle, guys. It could be practically any Ford vehicle with a hybrid battery. So hybrid vehicle, it could be Ford C-Max, Fusion, Lincoln, MKZ, Escape, multiple Ford vehicles nowadays use hybrid systems. And if you need to test the car battery, let's say you're buying a car second hand, or you have problems with the battery, you want to find out if all the cells are good or bad, stay with us. We will explain how you can easily do that without taking anything apart. All that will be covered in this video today. Before we start, let me tell you a little bit about us. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need, guys, in return, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, that way we can keep making these absolutely free videos to you. Now, if you guys need to buy any parts, tools for your Ford, you want to save quite a bit of money, we're going to put a link in the description of the video below where you can get all the parts and tools, and you can, guys, get them at an amazing price. That's where we get all our supplies, parts, tools, anything like that. So, what you need to do in order to test the hybrid battery on your Ford vehicle, you need to find the OBD port, guys. Okay, the OBD port is where you connect your scanner. So you go right here. You can see that's the scanner right here. The tool that we'll be using is the Tink Diag 2 right here. That's the tool. And let's go ahead. Okay, plug it in. Perfect. Now we need to turn the ignition switch on. It's extremely cold, by the way, this morning here in the garage. Also, that's the app that we'll be using, guys. That Tink 2, it's amazing too. It's practically like a dealer level equipment for a fraction of the price, guys. It can pay itself off in one time use. I'll definitely, guys, recommend it. Check out the link exactly which version we have. You can, guys, do so many things, but it works on almost any car you can think of. Check out the number of vehicles that it supports. It's unbelievable. It goes all the way down. So we click VIN decoding. It's going to read the VIN number and it's going to tell us, okay, exactly, guys, okay, which vehicle we have, which what year it is and all that stuff. So it should say Ford C-Max 2013 with the VIN number right there displayed. Follow the screen instructions, make sure the ignition switch is on. I'll recommend to test the hybrid battery only when the vehicle is charged all the way, okay? And sometimes in comparison, test it when it's charged all the way, and also charge it when it's about 1/3, so we can see that all the cells are healthy as well. We're going to go to system selection. Those are all the computers that we have just in this vehicle, guys. It's unbelievable. You definitely need a tool like that for this modern vehicle. So we're going to go to the hybrid system. Okay, let's see where it is actually. Battery energy control module right there. We're going to go what actuation test we have, just out of curiosity here. Let's see. Fan speed demanded, that's for the cooling. Special functions, charger, fresh air door calibration, energy, cell voltage. That's what we need, guys. You go to special functions, you go to the cell voltage right here. You're going to click that. Ensure that the parking brace is engaged in the vehicle and the wheels are locked at the front and rear of the vehicle. Are blocked. Okay, probably it may go in neutral. Click OK. Now it's going to analyze that. Give it a second. And this Ford C-Max plug-in hybrid, guys. Okay, it has 84 battery cells. So each one of those cells is the battery, guys. Okay, it's individual batteries. Each of those cells and all of them together, 84, make the battery of that vehicle. All the cells are kept between 2 volts and 4.3 volts. Ours is practically charged all the way now. And ours are about 4 volts, all of them. So we have some degradation after how many years? 9 years, because it's a 2013 model, now it's 2022. So it's important when you look, guys, to make sure that all the cells are about the same. If one is significantly lower or higher, that's when problems, okay, arise, guys. So you have to make sure that all of the cells are approximately the same when you're inspecting a hybrid vehicle. Let's say you have one that says 3 volts, or it says 3.7, but all of them are around 4. That's a problem, guys. Okay, it will develop a problem in the near future. So if you're buying a vehicle or something, check all the cells and make sure they don't deviate too much. What I'll recommend, charge the battery all the way, test it like that, then drive in, okay, and at about 30% range, test it again. Or even if you drop it almost all the way low, so you can make sure that they discharge correctly as well. But yeah, that's how you guys do it. You can see this procedure is displayed, measured cell voltage, and that's what it should be. So another thing, you can read data stream, and under data stream you can inspect here everything related to the battery, such as available battery charger input, the temperature of the battery, 50 degrees Fahrenheit, I told you it's cold, age of the battery, 93 months. And you can check all these things as well. Battery pack state of charge 94.84%. So our lost about 5.6%, guys. You can see right here 339 volts altogether. Delta model temperature degrees 35.6. Engine coolant temperature 44.6. Extremely cold. So you can see how many tests you can conduct here, guys. No errors, always check those as well. So everything looks great, but just you have to verify to make sure that you don't have any errors or anything like that. Hopefully the video will be helpful. Thank you for watching and see you next time.